Hello and welcome. I'm David Strom. We're looking at the small medium business main control panel of Verizon's computing as a service. If you want to quickly bring up Windows or Linux servers in the cloud and don't have a big budget, then CaaS SMB is worth taking a closer look at. We'll show you how to get started. Verizon is using a VMware-hosted service by Terremark, which enables you to set up virtual servers with just a web browser. Once you set up an account with a credit card and a valid phone number, you first need to create a server. Servers are organized by rows and groups. You click on the Create Server button, select whether you want just the server operating system or a database, choose Windows or Linux, and which OS version. Here you see the particulars for a Windows 2008 server. Next, you choose the number of virtual processors and how much RAM you want to provision on your server. And when you make your selections, you'll see the cost consequences of your decisions. You'll add disk storage later. You then fill out your server name and password, assign it an internal IP address from the pool of addresses available in your account, and a row in a group that the server will be located. You then click on the agreement, and your server will be created. Note on this screen is a message that you're charged for your resources, whether or not they're powered on. It takes a few minutes for your server to be created, and once it is, you go to the Network tab to set up internet-facing services and firewall rules. If we click on the Windows 2008 server listed on the left, we see its details, and clicking on the Nodes tab will show you the services that we've already set up, including FTP, remote desktop, and a web server. You can create as many services as you need depending on what apps you're going to run on these servers. Click on the Create Service button and fill out the dialog, and as you can see, the standard HTTP and other protocols are listed here. If it isn't listed, you set up a particular TCP port number and give it a name. Once you create your appropriate service, you click on the public IP address to make it accessible from the internet, and here you see the list of the services. You have to create a node to map the service on our Windows server with the public IP for that particular port. If everything is set up correctly, we can type in the IP, and here you see our variation of IIS screen. What if we need more disk storage than the default 40 gigs? We first power off the server, click on Configure, choose the Disks tab where we can add disk storage up to 500 gigabytes maximum per disk. You confirm the changes, and the next time you boot the server, you'll see this disk space available. To get a good look at what will be billed, click on My Account, Billing, and then Billing History, and you'll see your various usage charges. As you see, for each service we set up, we start accruing hourly charges. There are also charges for OS licenses, how much storage we provision, and other factors. Thanks for watching. You can see more information about Verizon's CaaS SMB platform at their website.